It's a fact, just a medical fact. That's what I wrote here. Or freeze these. So their complaints look like this.
There turns out that this numerical non-integral, but essentially for us it means that there exists no hope to find the Lax form. I mean, it's not a theorem, but it would be just time spent in vain to kind of look for integrability here. You kind of expect that if it is an integrable system, then with this very regular motion along Torrey, the corresponding coordinates of the iterations do not grow very fast.
And, it's just exponential.
It's a hidden exponential, but here when you take log-log, you see, you just observe the linear function. You see that it would not go constant after log-log, but still it grows, but slower than the linear function. And one can really kind of check that when on this example that you kind of really observe that it's not a linear growth for log-log of this quantity. There are no rigorous results in this direction, and it would be very interesting, for instance, assuming that one has a rational Lax form to prove that indeed that, for instance, integrability implies that the corresponding growth is slower, but there exists nothing in this direction. Okay, now. And recently, they did a paper by Anton Zosimov who showed that one can reformulate the pentagram map in terms of refactorization of some different separators. So I hope to get at least to give you some glimpse of that at the end of the talk. But I will now formulate some corollary of his theorem, and then explain how one can actually introduce a wider class of pentagram maps that covers all integrable, all known integrable cases, and essentially follows from his theorem.
You mean well, these two cases you explained?
Yeah,
this
Do they commute?
Huh? Do they commute?
What do you mean exactly?
You have two evolutions on the same space, so you may ask if they commute or not.
For different lines?
Yes, the completely different diagonals, though. At least I don't know.
Okay.
By the way, notice that even in these numerically non-integrable cases, when we consider the continuous limit that we did yesterday, we looked at those tuple of k's, I mean the jumps, how we define the corresponding plane for which we looked at the corresponding envelope. And for all k's, the limit is the same. We get the same integrable system. So the continuous limit is always integrable regardless of whether it is integrable or not in the discrete setting.
Are they different? Continuous limits are different?
They're the same, they differ only by scaling for different k's. They're the same Boussinesq hierarchy and KDV hierarchy.
So
regardless of what we consider, I mean, what kind of plane we consider here, it's still the same continuous limit. Now, so the theorem, corollary of theorem of Zosimov. That was last year. Is that he defined a different type of pentagram type, different type of pentagram-like maps, and it is as follows. So one can consider the pentagram-like map on polygons in the d-dimensional space, associated with a pair of subsets of integers, j plus and j minus. Maybe I should put it this way. So these are subsets of integers of total length, total number of elements. So length here stands for the number of elements, d plus 2. And they both are arithmetic sequences, arithmetic progressions with the same period. Yeah. So I'll give an example in a minute. And then, so once we have we have chosen such sets, so for instance, J minus will be 0, 3, and 6. And J plus will be, for instance, 2 and 5. Then the total length will be 5, and it is in RP3. So the claim is that the corresponding, so for defined by so it will be the intersection of pk corresponding to j minus with pk corresponding to j plus. Maybe I'll just put here j minus and j plus. Is an integrable. System. Example. Actually, that's exactly the example that almost the example that we discussed before. So for this case, I start with a pentagram map in RP3. I'll take a vertex with number. Oh yeah, I didn't define. Sorry. Pk j plus minus is defined is spanned by vk plus j, where j belongs to j plus minus.
Is it plane?
Now it's not necessarily a plane. So if I take j minus, it will be generated by 3 points. So this will be vk plus 3 and vk plus 6. And this one is generated by 2 vertices only, v2, vk plus 2, and vk plus 5. So this intersection will be the result of, defines the corresponding pentagram map, and it is, turns out to be an integrable system. And has kind of an anterior intersection, it was I discussed before. For instance, one can take for just the plane case, one can take just 2 vertices. This will be one arithmetic progression. The next 2 vertices is the second arithmetic progression. And it is exactly the original pentagram map. But this is, of course, a homogeneous situation. Now the question is how it kind of correlates with what I discussed before. There exists the following. So we introduced a new notion that we call the long diagonal pentagram maps, which essentially is equivalent to this one, and it covers all the cases like this and many more. So what is this?
But this case covers A, right?
This is only with with an arbitrary, this case covers everything that they just mentioned. So in particular here,